Welcome back everyone to the second video on the lesson of finite element analysis of thin beams. In the previous video we talked about the interpolation function and we were able to derive the shape functions. Now we are going to use those shape functions to create the element equations. Recall that from thin beam theory, the differential equation governing the deflection of the thin beam is given by this fourth order differential equation, where E is the modulus of elasticity, I is the second moment of area. Of course, I here is defined for homogeneous isotropic beams. If you don't really know these concepts, don't worry about them right now. They will appear when we get to the finite element modeling of composite structure. Anyway, for now, this is the deflection, the unknown function, the deflection, the lateral deflection of the beam, while the differential operator, in terms of, in the terms used in Newton's residual methods, the differential operator is this fourth order differential, with the second order directly operating on the lateral deflection, while the other second derivative is applied on the whole product here. F of x is the lateral force, it's the distributed force. As you may recall, there can be also concentrated forces, as we mentioned in the derivation of the interpolation function, but these will appear in the boundary terms, which we can use later as a loading vector as well. Now, when we substitute with the interpolation function, we get a residue because the differential equation cannot be balanced this way. So we use the Galerkin method on the residue to get this relation. It may look a bit confusing, but when we put it in terms of the in terms of vectors, it becomes a little bit easier to understand. Again, we apply the integration by parts twice to get this term, which is the which will create our stiffness matrix. Also, when we applied the integration by parts on this term, we got the boundary terms from which we could write this vector, the loading vector, which has the lateral forces and the moments applied at the end nodes of the element, while this term is the generalized force vector coming from the distributed force. And this cannot be evaluated explicitly until we have an f of x. Later in the examples, we will apply this integration using a few functions, but you can use it with any function you have. Anyway, we end up with the stiffness matrix here. We will derive, we will go through the usage of symbolic manipulators to get the stiffness matrix in the coming video. However, for now, this is the stiffness matrix for a beam bending that you will find in all the literature. And you can actually still work it by hand, although it's a little bit longer, not more difficult, but just longer than the one we did with bars. I don't recommend actually going by hand for the whole thing, but you may try a term or two just to see how it works. Also, here we have the generalized force vector due to the distributed force, which will be written as F1, F2, F3, F4 for the four generalized force terms. And remember, one of them is associated with a lateral or lateral deflection. The other is associated with the slope. So F2 and F4 may actually be called moments, but we will not use those terms. We will just reserve moments and forces for the terms of the concentrated force. So quickly, we have covered how we derive the finite element matrix of the thin beam from the Galerkin method. We will explore this using symbolic manipulators in the coming video, especially WX Maxima. Of course, you can use any other symbolic manipulator like Mathematica or MathCAD or whatever. Also, I would like to draw your attention that you may find the lecture notes with probably some more derivation or more explanation in a PDF file, which is linked through the Academy of Knowledge website, and it's posted and published in on the ResearchGate website. Okay, see you next video.